Madam Secretary, I want to talk a little bit about the Medicare backstop. You received a letter last week from Senator Rubio. If you recall that particular letter that came to your office, I also sent a letter to your predecessor on the same issues. And as you're probably aware of, the budget proposal has would reduce the bad debt payment from 65% to 25%. Now, in Nevada, we have 38 community hospitals. They handle almost 250,000 annual admissions and more than 2.7 million outpatients just last year. I'm particularly concerned for America's, and in particular Nevada's, rural hospitals, many of whom already operate on a very thin margin, and in order to provide care to these patients. So I guess given the issue, I'm troubled by the administration's continued effort to significantly cut bad debt payments. I'm also concerned this will have a very real impact on Nevada's hospitals and our senior population. If you would, please, could you share your justification for this particular policy?
Senator, I care deeply about rural America and these issues of rural. As I'm sure you can imagine, every time I have meetings, these are one of the questions I ask. And overall on the budget, in terms of how we support rural America in the areas of health care, there are a number of investments, and whether that's the community health centers, which disproportionately help rural America, or our investments in health care providers for rural America, there are a number of things that do that. With regard to this specific question of this provision, as we work to do something that I think you and others have said is a priority, which is entitlements and long-term changes in terms of structural reforms to entitlements so that we work on that long-term deficit. What we've tried to do is put together a balanced approach that is both has effects on beneficiaries and has effects on providers. When we make the decisions and choices about what we include, we try and do that on an analytical basis. In this case, we are trying to be parallel to what is happening in the private sector in terms of how they treat this issue. And so we're working to make sure that we are appropriately supporting rural communities, a very important thing, that health care in those communities and the economics of that. But this is an issue that is a part of our broader approach to making sure that we are addressing the long-term entitlement issues, which I think, you know, we look forward to working with the Congress. If there are ideas and approaches and specific policy changes that others believe are better than ours with regard to the package we have, we look forward to hearing those specifics.
Thanks for the answer. I would suggest that there's probably a real problem some of the rural hospitals outside of the state of Nevada, but I just want to go on record, Mr. Chairman, that I do vehemently oppose these cuts. And I don't think it's an issue that's going to go away anytime soon. So I'll remain concerned, but hope that we can continue the conversation.
And would welcome the alternatives and ideas about how we should address these long-term entitlements.
Thank you. I have one quick question, and that has to do with the projected savings in your budget. Last year, you projected over $414 billion over the next 10 years in savings, but this year it's been reduced to $250 billion. Can you explain why the proposed savings are so much less this year than compared to last year?
Two reasons. One is that some of the savings, as we go year by year, we're getting some of the savings in terms of the previous year, but also because we have proposals in our budget. And one of the proposals on the mandatory side, which we net out, so the number is a net number instead of a gross number. The gross number still is 423, but we decided that we would put in place investments, and those investments are mainly in the area of early learning and the idea of childcare, and the idea that for working Americans and people who are up to about 200% of poverty, that it's almost $10,000 a year to have your child cared for. And if you have a child that's between 0 and 3 and you're in that income bracket, we believe we want to encourage work and we want to encourage family. And so by helping with this child care issue, that's where the bulk of some of those investments are made.
Okay,
so we make a choice.
Thank you, Senator.